it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip Bacardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. When I pull up out front, you see the Benz on dub. When I roll 20 deep, it's always drama in the club. Now that I roll with Dre, everybody show me love. When you select them and them, you get plenty of groupies.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard, welcome aboard. We are here having a party today, celebrating 20 friggin' years. Yeah, a whopping 20 years, an astounding, use the adjective you want, 20 years on the air. And wow, that is awesome. And the only reason we're still on the air after 20 years is thanks to you guys. So today's a special show where we're going to have some fun. We're going to put you to the test. We're going to take a trip down memory lane, rememorar. So we're going to have tons of fun. But first, we're going to talk to our guests. Let me introduce all three of them. Ladies and gentlemen, Fitz, Richard, and Kyle in the house. We'll start off with Fitz, because I know, Fitz, you've got a jet. Te tienes que pirar. You've got a jet in a little bit. But Fitz, great to be here with you together, yeah, celebrating.
An honor to be here, too.
What's one of your greatest memories? Now, you've, even before you started working with Vaughan Radio, you were on board with Vaughan Radio. Do you have a favorite memory or something that stands out from your time either working on the radio or working in the company?
Well, in the company, I think, and maybe this was the case with all of us, I came to Spain thinking, I'll spend a year here. I never thought I would like teaching. Never, ever, ever.
Right.
I did my training, started with Mr. Miller over there on the 12th of January. Richard came in and inaugurated the training. And I remember this as if it were yesterday.
Wow.
This was the 12th of January 2004. And I remember asking you, I said, as well as the technical advice you said about correcting mistakes and using the style, I said, give us one piece of general advice about how to be a successful teacher. He said these words: flee from any possibility of being a boring teacher. And I thought, okay, that's all I need to know. That's like those words.
Right.
Flee from any possibility of being a boring teacher.
Flee, huir, yeah, to
that's flee.
Flee
with a double E, eh?
Not flee, yeah. Pulga, yeah.
Yeah. And that
it's great advice.
That is it.
Words of wisdom,
words
as
of wisdom.
We say.
Words of wisdom.
And you're a man who has always good advice, too. In fact, I always say, if you guys love Vaughan Radio, most of the people on Vaughan Radio have been trained by this man right here, Fitz. Well, most of the teachers as well. So I always say, you know, if you love what we do, then you love Fitz, because he taught us. He was, you know, the one who... all the teachers, not just here on the radio, but they all have your seal of approval, Fitz.
Because this gentleman over here, Mr. Vaughan, he taught me to teach everyone else. Shame. Yep.
He taught. That's the way it works. Yep. And we're still training teachers all the time, Vaughan teachers. And now you're here on the radio. What's one of your favorite things about working on the radio?
I think my favorite thing about the radio, because I've always been, as a kid growing up, radio was a big thing in my house. It was for sports. I always preferred, actually, radio sports commentary than the TV.
Oh, right.
And so I grew up with a lot of radio. And radio for me is a very, very personal thing between
absolutely.
The broadcaster and the listener, not the listeners.
Right.
I always feel I'm talking to one person.
Well, speaking of listeners, maybe we should hear from some listeners right now. We've gotten some really lovely messages, an outpouring of love. And as I said before, we wouldn't be celebrating anything if it weren't for you guys. So let's hear, Nacho, we've got some audio clips. Let's hear from our first listener.
Hello. My name is Andres. And today, I would like to say happy 20th birthday to Vaughan Radio, and especially to Julia and Jimena. Thank you, all of you, for guiding me for the right way. Thank you so, so much.
All right. Wow. Wow. That's one of the greatest things, too. Our students are not only learning English, but they're motivated. They're driven. Well, Kyle, Richard, how's it going, guys? Are you happy? You excited? Richard, 20 years on the air, 40 years, over 40 years as a company.
Well, since February 1977. So next February, in 2 months, it will be what? 46 years.
Yo soy de letras.
No, 47 years. 47.
Wow. 47. Yeah.
47 years. And many people think that the company's only 20 years old because of the because of the radio, I think. Because
the company in 2003, at the end of 2003, when we started this radio, the company was already 26 years old.
Wow.
And it was invoicing $4 million a year. So, I mean, it was an important company.
Right.
Although our clientele was 99% corporate.
Right.
And when we started the radio, we had a suddenly, you know, what they call physical persons.
Sure.
Personas físicas. Well, we had people coming, just lining up.
And yeah. It was incredible. It was like, a platform, and it still is. It's still a platform just to show people, listen, there is a good, fun way to learn English out there. You don't have to go to the traditional, let's repeat.
I was thinking this morning, it has to be the most impactful or revolutionary marketing tool in the history of language learning in Spain.
Yeah.
Can anyone name anything that created a greater marketing impact in the industry than Vaughan Radio with the Vaughan brand?
Not only in language teaching, I mean, the brutal power, marketing power of the Vaughan Radio was incredible in the first years. Now, the Spanish market has assimilated us. It's not a surprise. People say, los del inglés en la radio.
Right, you know,
it's a gift.
Like, yeah,
I'm not Alberto. Eres el de Vaughan.
El de la radio.
Okay, yeah.
Los de la radio.
You know, if we were to replicate this in any other city in Latin America, it would be probably even more. It would be a sociological phenomenon.
Right, right.
Really. I mean, it was an incredible surprise for people because we were broadcasting with enough power that if they hit the seek button, it stopped.
Ah.
You know, on this radio.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't skip. And so they said, what's this? Said, this guy speaking English, he's teaching.
I can understand him, kinda. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, you see, there's a secret there.
Ah.
You know, I knew that I had to speak, and I recommended to everybody not to speak slowly, but to speak high resolution.
Right, and use your words.
Yeah, you choose your vocabulary with a certain care, but yet being natural, of course.
Right, well, as a communicator, you would do that anyway.
High definition speech and good vocabulary, because I knew from my own experience with French that if I go to the back streets of Paris, I mean, I can speak French at level 7 over 10.
Mm-hmm.
But in the back streets of Paris, I understand French at level 2 over 10.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
But when I listened to, you know, to Jacques Chirac or Mitterrand speaking French, I was understanding 100%.
Right.
And it was a rush.
Sure.
Un subidón. And I said, my God. And it didn't matter what they were talking about.
Right.
I was hooked.
You were able to follow, and that was enough to keep you hooked.
And so it was like, it was a rush. I was like, wow. Yeah. And so I knew this could be emulated here through the radio. When people are when they stop understanding, Spanish people, when they feel inadequate, they switch. They escape.
Right, right.
And they did
fight or flight, as they say.
They were understanding perfectly, they were hooked.
Right.
And I've had so many people tell me, when I get to work down in the parking garage under the office, I stay there for 20 minutes listening.
Oh, wow. Yeah, 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 yeah. I've had that with a song, or we've all had it with you're listening. Wait, I want to hear the end of this debate or whatever. And it's true. It's true. I've had that same comment as well. All right. Well, we're going to find out a little bit more about the origins, but we got to hear from a lot of different listeners. So, Nacho, let's hear from another listener. And then we're going to hear about the beginnings. And we'll do some trivia as well.
Morning, everyone. This is Anix. Happy 20th anniversary, Vaughan Radio. I met you by chance, and I immediately got stuck to your radio waves. It was around 205. Oh, wait. It is almost since the beginning. Wow, how cool is that? Anyway, thank you for your job. Since I am listening to you day by day, my English really took off. Thank you for your job, for letting us be part of it. And it's really helpful. Thank you. I can't imagine my daily routine without you. And Alberto, someday I'll tell you how much your show means to me. You have been, you and your show have been with me through thick and thin, and it means a lot. Enjoy the day. Bye bye.
Wow, wow. Yeah. That confidence, you know, that confidence that only our students have.
That's something that I've heard a lot. I'm sure we've all heard that a lot, is that we end up being almost like psychology. Well, the English teacher ends up being a psychologist at some point to people. And the radio, a very comforting voice for a lot of people who are going through different things, and they want almost like a companion on their in their morning, in their day, in their evening, who's always there, a familiar voice that they tune in, they know at that time they can hear that person. And I've had so many people write to me and say, hey, you may not know me, but I know you and you're with me every day. And that's really flattering.
And I feel like that too, like you're saying, it's not just English. People are, you know, since we're giving a positive message, a yes, we can, let's enrich ourselves, let's empower ourselves. I think that's something people are drawn to as well, the positivity that we share. All right, well, Kyle, we've got a trivia question here with your first show.
I hope I can get it.
I'll have you ask it. I'll have you ask the question there.
What's the question?
It is about your first show. And then I want you to share one of your favorite memories from your show as well.
Okay, all right. Okay, so the first question is, what was the name of Kyle's first show on Vaughan Radio?
There you go, folks. The name of Kyle Miller's first show on Vaughan Radio. Let us know if you know it. We'll tell you in just a moment. Kyle, you've had some amazing interviews on the show. You've had artists, you've had astronauts, and everything in between. Why don't we play a little clip of one of these? Why don't you introduce it?
Okay. Well, a moment that was kind of fun for me was I got to interview the astronaut Chris Hadfield, who was the commander of the International Space Station. And that was a real pleasure because I had read his book, and he was such a fascinating figure and a guy who, I mean, he tells incredible stories. He learned Russian because he needed to be the commander of the International Space Station. He had to be able to also pilot the Russian Soyuz rocket.
Wow!
In case that he needed to navigate one back to Earth
and read the manual,
and in the case of any emergency, he would have to know. So he said, "Well, so I had to learn Russian."
Life or death.
And this is a guy we're talking about, elite level of ability to learn. Like, he was flying planes when he was like 12, and then he became a fighter pilot when he was 20 or something. Wow. Like, he just
superhuman.
And he said his whole life He said, I wanted to be an astronaut. He's Canadian. And he said, there was no path to becoming an astronaut in Canada. There's no NASA, recruitment in Canada.
In the States, so he just said, space camp and different steps.
He said, I'm going to take every step in my life. This is something I think we can translate to to other parts of life. He said, I'm going to take every step thinking, what would an astronaut do? So he said, I was 7 years old. Would the astronaut eat the potato chips or would he eat the healthy lunch? The healthy lunch. Everything, every decision.
So he started to be an astronaut before he really
and
was.
And he eventually became a fighter pilot, then training fighter pilots. Then he went to Florida. Anyway, a fascinating clip here when he was talking about the experience of the spacewalk, of being exiting the space station and walking
being
in space.
Being in space, something that very
being
few
in space.
People can
so
discuss.
So we have a short, I think it's about a minute. If we could hear that clip.
All right, let's hear it.
How do you actually exit for the spacewalk, and then what does that feel like?
Well, on the inside of the spaceship, it's sort of like being on Earth. We have air pressure and humidity and air and temperature. On the outside of the spaceship, you're in the ultimate emptiness vacuum of space. So you can't just open the door and go out, of course. And what you need to do is put on your big pressure suit, your space suit.
Yeah.
And then you have to go into a tiny airlock, close one end, pump all the air out of your airlock, and then vent it to space, and then open a hatch. And then the moment comes, Kyle, after a lifetime of preparation and planning, where you grab onto the sides of the hatch, you're floating weightless, you're in this inflated, extremely uncomfortable pressure suit, but you grab onto the hatch and you pull yourself out into space. And now you're holding onto the outside of a spaceship with one hand, with the whole world in the distance slowly turning in front of you, and then the whole universe all around you, and your whole link with everybody is in the fist of one hand. It's an amazing, instantaneously different place to be. And even though you've studied it, you know everything about your suit, and you've trained in vacuum chambers, and you've trained underwater, now suddenly it's real, and it's wildly different, and it's magnificently beautiful, and hugely dangerous, and very rare, and complex. Only 200 people in the whole history of humanity, there's 7.5 billion of us alive right now, only 200 people, there's probably that many people in your building, you know?
Yeah.
That only that many people have ever done a spacewalk. It's still a hugely rare human experience.
All right. Fascinating. What a guest, huh?
It was a lot of fun. And you can find that interview on YouTube, actually. If you search Vaughan Radio, astronaut Chris Hadfield, if you put those words in, you can find it all on YouTube, the full thing.
I mean, it's amazing. I don't know, you know, when this thing started, I don't know, Richard, did you think that we'd be interviewing ambassadors and astronauts, or did you envision it?
I never make plans. I envision outcomes, successful mm-hmm. outcomes of triumph or success, but I don't envision
the steps
along the way.
Gotcha.
Yep. I just knew it was going to be very successful.
Right.
Do we have time for a little anecdote?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, I'd love to. That's what we're
received,
here for.
I've easily more than 1,000 emails of people expressing their gratitude. But there's one I remember more than any.
Mm-hmm.
It was a young lady who worked at that time in Vodafone, whose offices at that time were in the Parque de las Moralejas, Parque Industrial Impresario. And she lived in Ciudad de los Ángeles in the south of Madrid.
Mm-hmm.
It took her 45 minutes every morning. And she said, she sent with a title, Vaughan Radio and the Theory of Relativity. And she said, before discovering Vaughan Radio, my 45-minute journey seemed like an hour and a half.
Uh-huh.
Since discovering Vaughan Radio, it seems like 15 minutes.
Wow. It does. I mean, I always tell the students, the show flies by for me.
Oh, yeah.
As the teachers, I'm like, whoa, are we really in the third part of the show already? And
yeah. Well, when I bring people for a class or for an interview,
mm-hmm.
they say, my God, already? We're finished?
Yeah, same. Every single time.
They're nervous, I can't believe. Right,
yeah,
right.
I can't believe. I had it last week. Yeah, we're done already?
What? Yeah.
That was an hour and a half?
You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
Yeah.
Right. Wow. So beautiful. Guys, we always get an outpouring of love. That's one of the most rewarding things about our jobs. Not only hearing you guys express yourselves with confidence in English, but also all the outpouring of love. Let's hear another message from one of our listeners, and then I want to hear how it all started.
Hey, it's Kubla. Congrats to Vaughan Radio and all those seasoned radio titans such as Richard, David, Guy, Fitz, Alberto, Kyle, Rob, Nashu, or Tash, and the not-so-veterans such as Andy, a chip off the old block, Ximena, Julia, and Alia. You've accomplished a milestone by reaching 2 decades of fun, uplifting, and edifying shows. Without a doubt, you've helped Spain raise its English knowledge and awareness by relentlessly lining up an outstanding crew over the years. We hope you to be on the air for at least another 4 lustrums. We do appreciate it. Take care. Kubla.
All right. There's again, these students are confident. And that's what I tell my students. We make mistakes, yeah, but as long as you're confident, you're good. I make mistakes. I get tongue-tied all the time. Kyle, before we hear about the origin story, what was the name of your first show on Vaughan Radio? Let's answer that trivia question.
It was called The Verb Circus.
Yeehaw! Yeah. The Verb Circus. No,
I like that music.
Can we still get The Verb Circus? Is it available anywhere?
It's on a CD in the Vaughan Tienda, ladies and gentlemen. You can get it on CD. And that name and that idea, you came up with me.
Yeah, together because, we collaborated.
Because Richard was offering me to do a show, and I knew I had to do something teachy. Mm-hmm. So we came up with this idea, let's focus on one verb and make a half-hour show.
Put it through the ringer, yeah.
And you said, what about like calling it like a circus, like make it fun and you know, like a game.
Yeah, so like that's different, where the idea feast your eyes from. Over mm-hmm. here. Now we're going to look at the phrasal verbs.
Correct. Right. And I will tell a quick, sure, just 30-second note about launching that show and my first shows. I remember Richard said, I want to hear four demos. It wasn't a demo. You said, I want to hear four. And it was very smart. I look back on that and I know why. Because, and you said, and it was very true, anyone can do one show really well. Yeah, and I think that's true. Anyone can do, you know, you sit down, you prepare it,
it's like
you
a
rehearse
presentation.
It, you go.
You do it
but
once.
But after doing two or three or four, you look at the quality of that fourth one, mm-hmm. and if it's still there,
great, yeah.
then you're all right. And I remember that. So I went off and I sat down with you and I said, I got to do four demos. And yeah, and you helped me through it. And we got, a long time ago now, and we got it done. And
I do remember you coming in and reading a little bit, and I was like, Kyle,
one, yeah.
give me that script.
Yeah.
I was like, we're not reading here.
We got to learn to wing it a little bit here, at
I'm
least.
Like, bullet points are fine, but no reading. All right, well, second question, and we'll answer it a little bit later on. Who was Fernanda's co-host on The Lighthouse? And now we're going to hear a little bit about the origin story. Richard, where did it all start? How did it all start?
It all started when a teacher on our team, Joe, Jose Luis Leon, Joe Leon from Los Angeles, Venezuelan parents. In fact, his father was a lawyer for the drug dealers in L.A. But he's a very good teacher. He popped his head into my office and said, hey, Richard, guess what? I said, what, Joe? I have a radio show. Oh, great. What's it called? Classic Rock with Joe Leon.
I said, sounds
wow,
cool.
I want to interview you. I said, well, I like classic rock, but I'm not necessarily an expert.
Mm.
No, this time different.
We'll wing it. Wasn't
I? Yeah, but what radio? And he says, Radio Cuatro Caminos. I said, I said, never heard of it. I said, what's the coverage? I don't know, 10 blocks. But because he was a good teacher, and a fantastic person, I'm not going to say no.
Yeah.
My philosophy is always to say yes. Because if you say no, you nullify potential opportunities.
Yeah. Yeah. Even in the future.
And so I went. I had to park a kilometer away and walk uphill. Mm-hmm. My God. Yeah, I got there panting.
A little bit out of breath.
But
yeah.
That was the first time in my life. I was 50 years old. That was the first time in my life that I experienced, 51, that I experienced a radio.
Right.
And so I put two and two together. You know, when you put
you have like an epiphany kind of
yeah. Okay, this is radio. I can teach through the radio.
I can use this medium to do what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Right.
Etc. And so it was through that.
Wow.
And so what I did was talk to the owner of that pirate radio, and I offered him €4,000 a month for 4 hours a day. And he said, I wanted to offer money that he would immediately say yes.
If you need to use my studio at home, let me know.
Yeah. But I wanted to do it. I didn't want to negotiate.
Right. Yeah, yeah. You were like, I'm going to make him an offer he can't refuse.
Yeah. Because, and to check it out. And within 2 weeks, I was convinced we can do this. And so I proceeded to make the necessary contacts to build a radio from scratch.
Right, find out a little bit what the necessities are.
Yes.
I imagine there's quite a budget involved. I mean, once you go from being pirate radio.
It cost €500,000.
Okay.
To set these things up from scratch.
And yeah, how long did it take to build?
Physically, I think it took about 3 months to build.
Okay.
We started, I think, in June. We started the program in Radio Cuatro Caminos. We started it in the last day of April, I remember, because May 1st was a holiday, but we did our program.
Mm-hmm.
And And then started in June, mid-June, we started the construction.
Mm-hmm.
But there are a lot of things to do. Also, the signal, the tower.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the polos, as you said. I don't know how to say it in English. Mm-hmm. And a lot of things. We put up a big antenna on the top of Birkin de Núria building.
Oh, wow, yeah. I remember that office.
I mean, if you go to that park and you step back and look up, you see an enormous tower.
Wow.
Is it still there?
Yeah, still there.
Wow.
Okay.
So there's a lot of logistics. I mean, that, you don't just snap your fingers and have a radio station.
No, it took...
You need also people.
Money, time, and hard work.
Absolutely.
And that was a great studio, by the way. I really enjoyed that studio.
It was very intimate, very... Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And there's nothing private. Like a basement. And where do you get the best sound? In a basement. Where's that sound going? Yeah. Where's it going? It's not going anywhere. Well, folks, we're going to learn more about the origin. We're also going to find out a little bit about who Fernanda's co-host was. And we're gonna remember his life a little bit when we come back. We're going to hear from you guys and so much more. So stick around. All right. I like that song, but I prefer the 50 Cent, It's Your Birthday. All right, guys, welcome back. Welcome back. We are rocking and rolling here, celebrating our 20th anniversary. And we're here in the studio with Kyle. And we've got another guest who has just joined us in the studio. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ruby. Morning.
Morning.
How you doing? Welcome aboard.
Thank you so much. I'm
great.
Good, thank you. How are you?
So I'm good. 20 years. Does it feel like 20 years?
Or not to me.
Like a month for you, it feels like, right?
Yeah. It's a month for me. Yeah.
So tell us a little, how's your first month going?
Great. I still get nervous. And I mean, very excited every time I come in here. Mm-hmm. But still nervous. I still get nervous. I still think about it way too much, probably.
But the thing is, I always say, you got to distinguish between the good nerves and the bad nerves.
It's good nerves, of course. Those
are the ones that propel
Absolutely.
You forward. The bad nerves are, oh shit, I'm not prepared.
I mean, the first few days, I have to say that although I was prepared.
You're not prepared for something you've never done.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, okay, I have.
You're like, I'm physically prepared.
Yeah, I've been a teacher for the past 5 years. So,
but not with a microphone in my face.
And live. You know? And
well,
live.
Well, in class, you're live. Think about it. What do you do in class? There's no, you know, okay, guys, wait, rewind. We're going to edit that part out of the class, you know?
No, but
tongue-tied and all.
Right. In class, like, the pressure's always on the student, whereas on the radio.
Right, I got you.
You see?
You're talking
for a full hour on your own.
Yeah. Or 2 hours in my case, two hours. But that's why I won also Class Chatterbox. So it worked out well for me over there. Well, welcome aboard. As I said, one of our newest additions here. It's a pleasure to have you on board. Did you know about Vaughan Radio before you worked with Vaughan? Had you heard of us before?
Oh, Yeah. I had. I never really listened to it.
My
dad from time to time. But I did know of it, of course, yeah.
That's awesome. That's great. Well, welcome aboard. And we're finding out a little bit about the origin story now. We also had a trivia question. Kyle, you want to answer that question? Who was Fernanda's co-host? I was going to say on the salad, on the lighthouse. Oh, God.
It was the one and only, the great Jim Traynor.
Jim Traynor. Yeah. We got to get a moment.
A nice round of applause
and a moment of silence, I think.
I'm sure Richard will give a proper backstory on Jim, but Jim really meant a lot to me.
Jim meant
and
a
he,
lot
he
to
He helped me a lot in
us.
My the early days, and just such a gentleman.
Yeah.
Such a gentleman, a professional, and a great friend, and an incredible voice.
Yeah. Let's have a quick moment of silence just for Jim, and then I want to hear a little Jim story from both of you. All right, that's weird. Radio, it's weird. People thought the radio. What happened to the radio? Kyle, you got a Jim story?
Well, I do, and it ties into Richard's story from talking about the very first days of Vaughan Radio before we even had Vaughan Radio, when he was renting the frequency in Cuatro Caminos.
Right.
So I had come to Spain to do a Vaughan Town program. I wasn't even teaching with Vaughan. I was contemplating, I was hoping to maybe get a job teaching at that point. Mm-hmm. And I had done radio in university and was just in love with radio. And Richard said, well, we have a radio project. We're possibly going to launch a radio, but I'm renting this frequency. Come to my show. Mm-hmm. So I go, okay, great. Give me the address. So he gives me the address. And one evening, I go to the show. I go to this building, and it's a residential. The way I remember, it was a residential building. Mm-hmm. And it's like un piso, like a normal apartment. I go in. And I knock on the door, and like that you guys were on the air. So someone came and let me in. And I think, was it in a bathroom or a kitchen? It was in a kitchen, I think.
No, the equipo de potencia, the power equipment was in the bathtub.
Oh, yeah, the power equipment was in the bathtub.
That's not the best acoustics, the bathroom. No.
And so.
Well, excuse me for playing the guitar.
Oh, yeah, for guitars and singing, but not for speaking. Yeah.
And I'll let Richard flush this out, but I will just finish on the Jim Trainor note. Jim was there. Richard, you were there. Fernando was there, and you were doing your show. During that show, you asked me to sing "O Canada," which I did. You're Cos from Canada. Hey, can you give us a few bars? Like, all right. So I sang my national anthem.
Can you draw some maple syrup from that tree?
And I was explaining. I said, "Well, I'm here on this Vaughan Town program. I'm not really working in Spain yet. I don't know how long I'm going to be here." Anyway, I left after the show. I leave. So I had met Jim. I leave and I'm walking home, and while I'm walking home, I go into this Irish bar, and the guy said, "Hey, we're looking for a waiter. Do you want to work behind the bar?" And I said, "All right, can you work right
Kyle,
now?"
Do you ever say no? You're like Richard. You say, come to the radio. Come work at the bar. Yeah.
Yeah. So the guy hires me. I had just finished telling everybody on the radio that I didn't have a job, and then I get hired. So I'm behind the bar, and then an hour later, Jim Trainor with this big group, he comes in.
Oh, wow.
And he's drinking beers. And so I go up and I'm like, "Can I get you a beer?" And he's like, "What the hell? You were on the radio with
me
around like 2 hours ago saying you didn't have a job." And he's like, "Yeah, I just got hired. I think I lasted 2 days in that job. I whatever. I still don't even know if I quit or they let me go because I didn't speak any Spanish and it wasn't for me. But it was funny because, I met Jim that same night. He was in with a big crowd and... But Jim then became a very good friend, and when I started the radio myself, like I said, he was sort of a constant down there, the morning or the daytime anchor, really, of Vaughan Radio, really, during the day.
And you would hear him warming up around the office. Bo, 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 bo. He was he would do those, because he was an actor as well. Mm-hmm. He was with the Madrid Players, so he was always doing these vocal techniques. Definitely a pro, and one of a kind. Richard, how about you? I'm sure you have many memories with Jim Trainor.
Well, Jim Trainor worked with me as a teacher before, but I knew that he had some experience in the radio because on the original Antena 3, going back at the very beginning in the late 80s, he had a morning show from 6 to 8 in the morning called, I think it was called Radio No Sé Qué Golden Line. So I knew he had experience. Second, I knew that he had probably the most beautiful, most impressive baritone voice imaginable. It's a pity. I don't know if Nacho could find his voice somewhere.
I'm sure.
And we could listen
somewhere.
To that voice.
Yeah.
What was paradoxical about his voice was it was so beautiful and so singular.
Yeah.
It's not like the typical radio voice. Mm-hmm. For example, Danny. The radio voice, which is a fantastic
booming,
Spanish radio voice. Mm. But it had that baritone. But people complained that they couldn't understand.
Oh, because it's Northern England, sure.
Well, no, the accent was clear. For native people...
I understood him fine, yeah.
For native people, it's no problem. But Spanish people had trouble.
Oh, right.
I think it was how he chose vocabulary and how he connected syllables and things that they found it very difficult, not only on the radio, but in Vaughan Town as well, when he went occasionally as a participant. Mm-hmm. And they had trouble understanding him. They loved to listen to the timbre of his voice, but they didn't. They couldn't understand
him. They couldn't understand,
In his 20s, he was a Catholic priest.
Oh, wow.
He grew up, I think he grew up in an area of England that's predominantly Catholic, in Newcastle.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, it's interesting. The people in Newcastle don't say Newcastle. They say Newcastle.
Oh, the accent's on the second part.
Yeah, like New York. No one says New York.
No.
New York.
New York.
New Amsterdam.
New York. New York.
But, and so he had a certain a type of personality that's quite different because of his background and things. But he was a very memorable person. And,
one of a kind.
And the fact that the program was with Fernanda, in which he spoke English that people had trouble understanding, and she spoke Spanish.
Right,
so it
right.
was an ongoing conversation in two languages simultaneously.
Yeah.
And people really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was a nice, definitely a nice, nice show where you could just sit back, like your favorite chair, kind of.
Yeah.
And just feel comfortable. And that's what Jim did. He made not just the listeners, but he made us feel comfortable as his friends as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, he always said, the lighthouse, which takes you to a safe haven with your English.
There you go. That's exact. I mean, perfect tagline. All right. Well, the third trivia question here. Let's see. Ruby, I'm going to put you to the test.
Oh,
I know. I don't expect you to know it. Just for shits and giggles.
All right. Okay.
What is the, and this is a trick question too, what is the longest running show on Vaughan Radio? The longest running show.
Did you just say it was a trick question?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's three options. There's...
Don't look at Nacho. Nacho's not going to help you.
I was thinking about three options, right? We've got Richard Vaughan.
But don't confuse the person with the show.
Yeah, I know, that's where the technicality comes in.
Excuse me, the person with the title of the show.
The title of the show.
Well, right. we'll look at both. Why not?
Well, Kyle, you've been doing this for very long, Kyle, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Like what, 17 years?
Yeah, since...
More or less?
Since...
Am I allowed to ask questions? I'm asking questions.
Yeah, yeah,
I don't even know. 16, something like that. Yeah.
Look, and then we have...
Rob just showed it to you.
And then we have David, right?
Yeah.
Right, and his show's name is?
The Salad.
The Salad. Uh-huh. And David's been... I was talking to Dino about this because I was talking to him here while David was doing the show, and he told me how long he'd been doing it for, and I think it's longer than Kyle.
So then, your final answer...
The Salad?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, the Salad.
The longest running show with the same name.
All right.
Now, okay. Richard's been on the air the same amount of time, but his show, it was originally called Cloverdale's Corner.
Uh-huh. Correct. Yeah.
Okay.
I wanted to have a pseudonym. I didn't want people to identify Richard Vaughan as the owner and manager with the radio personality.
Right.
So I decided to use that pseudonym. And it lasted about 8 years, and it did fool people. It was fool. Yeah. I don't know if I said it in the previous half hour.
No.
But I remember there are a lot of people on the social networks, on the internet, saying, Richard Vaughan, or Cloverdale, I mean, is he Richard Vaughan?
Yeah. I always told people, I'm like, I can't tell you. I can't tell you anything, or I have to kill you.
Well, what's funny about this, two anecdotes. Number one, one anecdote. And I was in a meeting in Sony Entertainment. And one of the managers at Sony said, you know, Richard, you're so lucky to have an employee like Cloverdale.
You're like, should I give him a raise? Should I give the guy a raise or what?
Yeah.
And how long have you been?
Longer than I can count. So I've been on the air, I think, 15 years. And I've been with the company maybe four or five years before. That's almost 20 years with the company.
The thing is, when you create a pseudonym or you create a personality, you need to be careful because it can be very disappointing for listeners when they discover that the person doesn't exist.
Right.
You know, I mean, I had a guy, I had a famous, a well-known comedian here in Spain. He assumed Professor Nicolas Carvajal.
Yeah.
An 84-year-old. Retired professor of physics.
Right. Sure. Well, that's the good thing about the radio. You can be anybody.
And you had Willy Wong.
And Willy Wong.
Nobody knows that better than Dave Boyce. You can be anybody on the radio.
Oh, yeah.
He interviews himself. He interviews
David Beckham.
He's manic.
All the time.
I honestly don't know how Dave keeps up with himself.
He puts on voices of Sean Connery.
Yeah.
And
but
David
at the same
Beckham.
Time, yeah. switching back. I mean, it's insane. Yeah.
I remember he interviewed Mick Jagger and Keith Richard.
He put
the voices of the two, and he'd say, Mick, Keith's not answering me. And Mick says, oh, it's because you fell asleep.
great talent over there. Dave Boyce. So, yes, the longest running show is The Salad, but Richard's been on the air just with a change of names. I'll give you the next question, and then we're going to hear from a listener. The next trivia question. Easy one. Who was the host of the former show Highways and Byways on Vaughan Radio? the former host of Highways and Byways. Nacho, you're not allowed to answer these questions because I know you know the answer to all of them. All right, let's hear from another listener.
Hi there. It's Chris Balron. I've been listening to Vaughan Radio for 5 years, and I love every single show. I learn not only English, but much more. I have a blast, and I've met great people throughout these years. I want to say thank you, Vaughan team, Vaughan family. You are the business. And thank you, Richard, for being a visionary, at least in my book, and creating this amazing thing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And let's go for another 20 years. Bye-bye.
All right. Again, all of our students, man, they may make a mistake here or there from time, but the confidence is unmistakable. Mm-hmm. And that's something that the Vaughan method does. It gives the student the confidence to say, okay, I will make mistakes. It's part of the process, but I'm going to get it out and I'm going to say it with confidence. And that goes a long way.
Yeah.
That goes a really long way. You know, just being able to say, okay, I'm imperfect, but I'm going to get it out.
Yeah.
You know, a person who listens to this half an hour a day, in the end, over a 5-year period, they accumulate up to 1,000 hours of exposure to the language, and it becomes a friend.
Sure. Well, look at Chris is the perfect example that we just heard. She listens all day, every day, while she's doing other things, and she didn't seem uncomfortable at all speaking the language.
I had lunch the other day with a very famous ex-surgeon who now is a confidenciante, a speaker. Mm-hmm. He's on speaking circuit. He told me he was and he speaks almost perfect English. He lived for 3 years in the U.S. as a doctor. And a taxi driver, was listening to Vaughan Radio. Mm-hmm. And he said, do you listen to this a lot? He said, yes. Can you understand? Said, yes. And let's speak English. And the taxi driver spoke English better than he did.
Oh, man.
According to him, according to the doctor. Mm-hmm. And said, he was shocked. He was surprised. He said, the taxi driver. But we've had a lot of taxi drivers.
Oh, my God. I can name five now. Borislav, Francisco. I mean, Borislav, we've got a lot of taxi drivers.
Borislav is a Bulgarian.
That's right.
Taxi driver. And he's not driving taxis now.
That's right. He changed.
He's successfully in other businesses now. He's an excellent
good
person.
Good for him. Intelligent. He always gives me aviation stuff because he knows I'm an AV geek. So, But that's the wonderful thing. Our listeners, I feel like I say it on the show every day. I'm like, you guys are not just my students. You're kind of like my family. You know, I expect you every day. And like, you know, it's a really, really special bond. Because also, like you said, the radio is very intimate. But also normally on the radio, you're telling a story, you're giving news. Here, we're teaching them. We're actually, and so it gives it a very special connection, because it's not like we're just entertaining you like Pablo Motos or one of these people on TV, but we're also trying to make you a better version of yourself if you stick with us. Not just, and I like to think not just with their English. Mm-hmm. I like to think that all of us use the platform as well to empower people to take their to take charge of their life, to start a business, to do. Fran, one of our listeners, Fran, he's probably listening right now. He's a photographer, and he started telling me, oh, I've got photographs of this person. I photographed this one and Rita Hayworth. And I'm like, dude, you should write a book. Well, famous last words. He wrote a book.
Oh, wow.
So I like to think we're giving people a little more than English over here, too. Because there's a lot of negativity. You know, you turn on the news and it's just like, you know, Gaza, this, that. You're like, please, no.
We're exposing them also to different culture, the British, the Irish, the American, Canadian. You know, the Anglo-Saxon culture and the Irish culture, it's just different. A lot of Spanish people don't really travel too much abroad, and they don't have, and so it's giving them, it's broadening their horizon.
Yeah, an insight a little bit. Yeah, because we always, I mean, it's something especially because we look at, on the show, with our name, movies and music, I always stress the cultural element that is learning a language. We're not just learning expressions and structures. We're learning how people think. Mm. You know, how people see the world. And I think that's one of the fascinating things about that. And somebody who was really good at that, and this will bring us to segue our fourth question, was Drew Crosby.
Yeah.
He was the host of Highways and Byways. A little anecdote about Drew. I know he was a fishmonger. What a great communicator.
Fishmonger, really?
He was a fishmonger, yeah. In San Francisco.
No, in Seattle.
Oh, Seattle. Sorry. See, you know, tell us a little bit about Drew. He's no longer with us, not in the same way Jim Traynor. But
Drew started working with me in about 1988 as a teacher. And then he married, and in 1991, he went to Chicago. They lived in Chicago for about 4 or 5 years, and then they went to Seattle, or vice versa. They went to Seattle first. And he worked in the fish docks and with fish. Mm-hmm. And it was interesting. It said, when you go home, your hands smell of fish.
Stink, fish. I can imagine.
He said, you can wash your hands 100 times. It does not go away.
I imagine. It goes into your pores.
A month. Before,
yeah,
being away from the fish.
Jeez Louise.
and then they came back to Spain. And he started teaching again. And when I started the radio, when he found out that I was starting a radio, he sought me out.
He jumped on that opportunity.
He said, can I? And of course I said, yes, sure, yeah. Drew. He's a good teacher.
And he was a great teacher and really knowledgeable about Americana, music, Route 60.
I loved listening to his show. It was great. Yeah, the sections were great, talking about music. Mm-hmm. And it was great.
Yeah, because Vaughan Radio, we've got, you know, Ruby, we've got Chris, they're new. But Vaughan Radio is also a lot of people who have come through here who are still a part of Vaughan Radio. A perfect example, Claire Williams and Alvaro Quesada. They're still in my jingles on the show with no name. Sure. I hear Claire Williams every day. So her little contribution, her 2 cents, is still felt in Vaughan Radio and a lot of people. And that brings us to our fifth trivia question. What DJ composed many of the Show With No Name jingles, including the Totally Native, which is a very famous jingle? There's one right over there.
Is the show.
These. Yeah. These fun jingles. We used to do it. I think we were talking about starting our own boy band and everything. We were, you know, practicing all the moves. So, all right. Well, we'll take a look at the answer to that. Let's hear from another listener, and then we'll check out some other stuff.
Hello, my name is Johan. I'm from Colombia, and I just want to thank you for all the great work you do at Vaughan Radio. I have learned a lot with your shows, especially the one from Kyle and with Richard as well. So thank you guys for all what you do for us and congratulations for your anniversary. Bye.
All right. Awesome stuff. And Ruby, what about you? What have you noticed about that connection with the listeners? I'm sure they welcomed you with open arms.
Yes, I have to say that they did. And I mean, at the beginning, obviously, for me, it was quite weird to, I was here by myself, but I didn't feel like I was alone, which is what I feel is great about the radio, because, you know, it's not like you are doing something by yourself, although you are, entre comillas, no? Like, but I can feel
the connection.
I can feel that people are listening. And sometimes I find myself saying, well done, because I'm imagining someone, like, you know? And I'm like, yeah, well done. I'm thinking, all right, you know? but I can imagine people there. And for me, I've noticed, I get a few comments here and there already, like on Instagram or on Twitter, that I never expected so early on. And to me, it really makes me want to just keep going and do it better. And so I feel, of course, that's what I felt up to this point.
Yeah, I say it to them.
I don't feel alone, even though I'm
by myself. No, not at all. I always say that those comments are our fuel.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, when you read a comment, you wake up in the morning, I wake up and, you know, I'm making some coffee and I read, oh, Alberto, your show's all, whatever. You know, some random comment and I'm like, ding, I start my day with a huge smile. And not many people get that job satisfaction, because if you're waiting for your company to pat you on the back, they don't normally do that. Because that means they have to pay you more money.
99% of all of the feedback from listeners has been extremely positive.
Oh, of course. No, and life-changing, as Kyle said, not just, you know, I finally grabbed my life by the horns. Because you guys motivated me, something you said, just like if something you said motivated Fitz back in the day when you said, stray away from boring teachers or
flee.
From flee. Well, just to give them another vocabulary word over there.
But stray away is not as much as flee.
Run away. Well, the answer to question number 5, Kyle, why don't you give us the answer to which DJ did a lot of those funky jingles that we still hear today?
Well, that was Martin right. Gamarra, a.k.a. DJ Spanglish.
That's right.
In fact, I saw him a couple weeks ago.
Oh, wow.
Because I occasionally do a bit of voiceover work, and uh-huh. he works at a great studio, and I ended up going in there to do a little project.
Great.
He's a great guy.
Great guy. Super talented, and just another person who has gone, you know, come and gone as life is. You know, not everybody stays and left their mark. Like
he
Drew.
Saved my life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How did
well, more, who knows?
Oh, tell us. Wait, now you,
you have to.
Now we're interested.
Yeah.
No, in the old studio in Birkenenudia, well, one of the lights had a some type of short circuit.
Oh, short circuit.
It started fire.
Oh, Jesus.
It started burning. That light was burning.
Fuck.
And you know how easily this type of
oh,
material
yeah, that
can
foam,
burn.
Oh, yeah, it's flammable.
He walked out of the control room, got the fire extinguisher, and walked in and whoosh,
oh,
like
wow.
an expert.
No hesitation.
Wow. No hesitation. He knew what to do.
No, I didn't know that. The time that Martin oh. saved Richard's life.
Yeah.
Well... Potentially.
Well, potentially. You never know.
We had a few interesting on. I was on the air once and the power went out in the whole building.
Oh,
and I kept talking because I didn't know if maybe the radio was still going. I kept going. The lights were out and Tino or whoever ran in, or maybe it was Nacho. He's like, no, we're done. We're
done,
off
man.
The air. Like, okay.
No, there was once in the old studio. That I had
it was
to
in
do,
the basement studio.
I had to do the 3 hours completely. There was a problem. We couldn't take the breaks.
Oh, Jesus.
And so I had to talk for 3 hours straight.
Oh
all right. Well, folks, we're going to reminisce some more when we come back. We're going to a quick commercial break, so stick around. Ladies and gentlemen, we are rocking and rolling here for our 20th anniversary bash. We're here on the show with No Name, rocking with Richard and Kyle and other special guests. And guess who's joining us in the studio right now? You'll know as soon as you hear her voice.
Hi.
There she Hi. Is.
A typical Texas accent, right?
Totally. I know. I've been working on it for weeks.
I'm from East Dallas. Texas. East West Texas.
Yep. I'm from Turkey, Texas. I heard that's a place.
Is it?
Yeah.
I believe it.
Thanksgiving.
But don't mess with Texas. Don't mess with Texas. That's their...
Whoa,
mess with the microphone. Nacho just had a heart attack right there with that, right?
Yeah.
Nacho's like...
There we go.
What just happened? You're going to pay for that in today's Test Your English.
Totally. Sorry.
All right. Well, welcome, Ximena. What's one? We're going to hear from Nacho, too, your cohort, your partner
Indeed.
In crime in a moment. But what's one of your fondest memories or funny moments here at Vaughan Radio? I know your show is
good
full of them.
Good putting me on the spot.
That's
Excellent.
My job. That's my job here today.
I do have a very fond memory.
All right.
You might not remember this, but... It was,
oh, this sounds good already.
Yeah.
I was drunk. I'm sorry. No, I'm joking.
No, I can't. I've got the world's worst memory. There's
okay.
no one worse than me. But I do remember in Birkenenudia, coming on your show, and it was either, I like this romantic music in the background. Put it
yeah,
up.
Nacho's
sure. Yeah,
Nacho's
trying
to make me cry. He's pulling on my heartstrings over here.
I think it was my birthday.
Okay.
I think I was all alone in Madrid. And I think you whipped out a happy birthday, Ximena crown. And it was the best day ever.
And Allison was there. There's a picture of that.
Yes. Oh, is there a picture? Oh,
I remember seeing a picture of that. You know, when your phone reminds you 7 years ago, whatever.
It was longer. It must have been
I don't
longer.
Know. I'm saying seven just to say seven. But But wow, great memory. Celebrating your birthday at Virgen de Nuria Studios.
Indeed. Those were good times. And then the little cafes there afterwards.
Oh, yeah. I the cafe. Well, you can just say beer. We don't have to lie to them, you know.
Come on.
The tercios that we had after.
Have you ever met an Englishwoman?
An Englishman.
Yeah. As bubbly as she is.
I think she gets she's got the Argentine blood. That's what it is.
I'm not sure. Maybe, yeah. No, I think one day it's going to hit me.
And one day you're just going to get serious, yeah? Like, and be like, yeah. It's not funny, mate. It's not funny. Stop messing around. Stop faffing about.
Yeah. Indeed.
Stop faffing around. They're going to suss it out.
It's coming for me.
Faffing about. Were you nervous on your first radio show?
Good question.
Really good question. Yeah, I think I was terrified.
Shitting bricks or like...
It was tea time teacher. Do you remember?
Yeah, but you had taught before, so you were nervous about the radio thing. Because you had done
TV stuff. No, but I think
TV
as
stuff.
Long as I can't, like, as long as I just have to speak here, I'm fine. Because I can waffle. Waffling is my thing.
Okay.
I remember doing it.
Waffle is a British term for just getting by.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for translating.
Did somebody say chicken and waffles?
Waffle House.
No, I remember what really did scare me was with Rob, maybe, the TV test. Maybe it was Alberto.
Oh,
and I don't think there's anything sadder that got filmed. You were like, just try to lighten it up a bit.
And I'm natural.
Like, is this a phone?
Rob,
no.
Do we have that footage? It's like when you see everybody's original Saturday Night Live auditions. You're like, oh my God.
Yeah, no, those were sad times.
So some funny
moments.
You were
like, come back in 3 months when you know some Spanish.
So that was Tea Time Teacher, which was awesome.
Yep.
And now you've got Test Nachos English.
Basically,
the name of your new show is Test Nachos English. Nacho, how's it hanging, buddy?
Hello. Hello, everybody.
How are you?
Fine. And excited to be here. We're celebrating the 20th anniversary.
And Nacho, I guess I'll have you answer our next question.
Maybe I know it. Yeah, I know the answer.
Who is our longest serving radio technician, sound designer?
Well, I think it's me.
Yes. I think.
He's like, there were a couple times when it was questionable.
But now officially it's me. Maybe there was a time that it was Danny or me, but now it's me.
Now
definitely.
It's you. How long have you been here? I know you know the day you started because it was a very special day.
I know it exactly because it was my birthday on 2008. So I've been here more than 15 years.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
You put the V in Vaughan.
Yeah. Yes, for the A, but not the B, but I'll use the A. Yeah.
And yes, I will, as we say, take my hat off, take my cap off to you and Tino as well,
yeah,
who does my
team.
Show. Mm-hmm. You guys do an incredible job. Incredible job.
Yeah, because they don't just like press record here. They have to like all the materials that Ximena's department puts out, and that's a lot.
That's a lot. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
They're always booking the studio over here, making life hard for the presenters, but don't worry, guys.
Otherwise they get bored.
And Nacho's like, oh, great, so I have another project.
Exactly.
Oh, great. Exciting. No, but seriously, they do so much more than just press record and, you know,
and
make
pretty.
Sure
and
look pretty. I mean, that's hard enough, the looking pretty. Nacho, one of your favorite memories or maybe something that stands out?
Well, I have a lot. Mm-hmm. We have remembered. I don't know, it's been 15
we
years
reminded
still,
people.
Nacho.
Still,
yes, Gene Trainor, for example, it was my first show. And it was the first show of every single technician was with Jim. Because he was so nice, so kind.
Is that why they did it?
Yes, he was so nice, so kind. I did it.
Yeah, he wasn't like, give me this, give me this. I'm the opposite of the show with no name, basically. Yes,
exactly. I was like scared, trembling, like, and I did it horrible. Like, I left the music like in the background the whole half an hour. Jim was making me signs, but with a beautiful face, like, you know, like, baja, I didn't know what he meant, and but he was very nice. But also, thank you for Jim for in name of all technicians.
Yeah.
And a funny story was that my first appearance on the radio was not, of course, in Test Your English, it's the last, and with you, Alberto, with Kyle.
Sure.
I've been in your shows, And my first appearance was in the Magic Hour. The Magic Hour.
Was
a show for kids. And Marilyn used to have kids.
Marilyn,
real kids. But a day the kid couldn't make it, and he
said, "Oh no!
I need one kid. I need one kid."
You were not.
Then, brilliant.
Come here. And then,
hola.
Oh my God.
Mama. Yeah.
We have to change your name, and I still remember I was Antonio for
this
show.
You're like, I'm not getting paid Antonio. To do this.
So I was like, how old are you, Antonio? I'm 14.
My voice changed last night.
It was very funny. It was very funny.
Oh man, great! What one of the things I love about Nacho? I mean, obviously he's one of our great friends and very talented. But the reaction he gets when people come to visit us here at the studio—they're like, "I'm like Nacho, can you put this audio?" And they're like, "Not you're the Nacho.
Yeah, yeah.
You're not like he's Elvis. Yeah, yeah. It's crazy.
Amazing. I've even signed books in the book.
Incredible. Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, it's I think from the very first day, I included the sound technician.
Yeah.
And I've never seen that on another radio.
Yeah, they're not celebrities in their own right.
And I included I referred to the sound technician always by his name or her name.
Right.
Always. And so, and then it became, it's a constant here on this radio.
Sure. Yeah.
But you go to any other radio, at the end of the program, many times a DJ will say, and I want to thank the technical staff. I want to thank Juan Pab. And they, you know.
They have their own jingles here. Nacho, Nacho Man.
Macho Man.
Yeah, we got Nacho Man. And
Testar then, Nacho, exactly.
And what's the other one?
I do vocabulary. I do Tino Time.
Tino Time. And there was another one, too, that, Juanjo or another.
Amazing.
We're going to find you. We're going to get you. Juanjo. So it's cool. You guys are a part of the team as well, not just here behind the scenes, but also, and Nacho, you even do some of our ads now. They've talked you into doing some of our, ahora te puedes apuntar a los Master de Vaughan.
Exactly. That's, how do you say that? Due to unforeseen
circumstances.
Yes.
That's in the translation book.
Yeah, yeah. Due to unforeseen. We had to call off the meeting due to unforeseen.
I think we were forced
to call off the show. Tuvimos que cancelar el espectáculo.
Oh, God, you guys. You've got problems.
We know the Vaughan method inside and out. We do it by the book, as the expression goes.
I learned so much Spanish through those translation lists.
Oh, yeah, a lot.
All right. Well, speaking of books, here's our next question. We're doing some trivia questions here today. Which Vaughan radio presenter is a composer who has even written a kid's book with songs? You should know this because of your department.
Yeah, but it's not Richard, is it?
Richard's a composer too, but he didn't write a kid's book with songs.
Oh, I know this, of course. I know.
All right, go ahead. You can give it to us.
I wrote a book with songs with Rochelle.
Yes,
but not a kid's book. The key word is kid's book.
David Boys.
That's right. The host of The Salad, which is the longest running show with the same name.
I love it.
His
show. You changed your name and you lost your accolade.
I lost my what? Accolade.
Oh, Richard.
All right. Well, again, something the technicians are part of the family. Also, our listeners are part of the family. And we've been hearing from them all throughout the show. Let's hear from another listener right now. And then we're going to check out another little interview that Kyle Miller did on the Drive Time show with the one and only Andrea Kor.
Oh, yeah.
So that's coming up next. Let's hear from one of our listeners first.
Hello, everyone. My name is Laura. I've been listening to Vaughan Radio for over 15 years, and I can say that it has changed my everyday life for the better. Besides keeping me company, listening to Vaughan Radio has made everyday boring tasks much more productive, and it has helped me keep my English on track and improve it, always in a really fun way. It has also been a source of inspiration for me in my current job. Over the last 2 years, I've been able to participate much more on the show with No Name, with AA, and meet some of my fellow students and some of the awesome Vaughan teachers at the last two book fairs. And now I feel part of a lovely community. Thank you, Richard Vaughan, for having created the best and more effective method for learning English and for having managed to surround yourself with the best teachers and even greater human beings. Happy 20th anniversary, Vaughan Radio. Thank you so much for existing.
And the only expression that comes to mind is, Laura, you have a way with words.
Oh, my goodness,
she's
Laura.
And she speaks Italian. She's originally from Italy, so Italian, Spanish, and English. Very well, very confident. And another guy who speaks English and very confident, but you never know what voice he's going to give you, is our great friend Dave Boys.
Hi, folks. It's Dave here from The Salad Show. Can you believe it's been 20 years since we first started Vaughan Radio? That's right. It's our 20th anniversary. And I've been here since day one, so I can tell you time has flown. Time flies when you're having fun, as we say in English, and that's certainly been the case here. So thanks for joining us on this incredible journey, and here's to 20 more.
All right, Dave Boys, the nice. Gifted. I love that word, gift, because talented is a good word, but gift, if you have a gift, like that's a good way to look at it. Like you got to take care of that gift, and Dave is definitely gifted. His book is called Canciones para
con animales
para aprender inglés. If there are any parents listening, music is such an amazing way to learn. I know it with my daughter. I was able to teach her about astronomy because of Queen.
What?
Galileo. And she goes, who's Galileo? I'm like, he's an astronomer. And she goes, what's an astronomer? Because everything actually, an astronomer is somebody who looks at the stars and the planets. And so, we're learning with music, not just with, but, you know, about historical things as well. And speaking of music, Kyle, you've had some great musical guests, Danko Jones. They call him Danko Jones in Spanish.
Yeah. And he loves that.
And he loves it, by the way. At the concert, he goes, because everybody's chanting, Danko Jones. His name's...
Danko Jones.
He's like
a hardcore Jones
guy.
So yeah. The guy, everybody in the audience, he was over here at one of the salas, Danko Jones. And then all of a sudden, he's like confused. He's like, what are they saying?
Yeah.
And then the guitarist whispers in his ear, and he's like, oh, you motherfucker. He goes, you call me Don Cojones? He's like, no, Senor Don Cojones.
Yeah.
And it was great. The whole crowd just realized the moment he realized his Spanish nickname. But you've interviewed all kinds of artists, Kyle, and you've even learned a little bit from these artists.
Yeah, well, I've started interviewing musicians, and this one was one where the record label actually wrote me and said, hey, can Andrea Kaur come to your show for an interview?
Nope.
And I said, of course, that'd be great. You know, of course, from the Kaurs, very, very well-known group.
Mm-hmm.
And so I thought, okay, I was sort of doing my research and I thought, okay, I know she plays the tin whistle. So I'm going to go ahead and buy a couple of tin whistles and see if she could teach me the tin whistle. So what you're going to hear, I think, is the track where she's teaching me. It's only like 30 seconds or so. She's teaching me, quote unquote. I try horribly, but then she plays a nice bit. But the funny thing about this, after the show, I had purchased one cheap tin whistle and I had borrowed another one from a friend. And later in the interview, she says, oh, can I keep this tin whistle? Mm-hmm. And I had to tell her no. I said, no, sorry. And I think she was like, nobody ever says no to this.
Exactly.
And I was like, what? It was like a four-year-old thing. But she said, and I said, no, I'm sorry. It's not mine to give away. I had to borrow it from a friend.
Oh,
but anyway, so this was the clip where Andrea Kaur is teaching me how to play the Irish tin whistle.
Can you give me a little crash course
here? Okay.
What do I have to?
Well, just lift your fingers off to the scale.
How do you keep control of it?
Well, go there.
Oh, am I doing something
wrong? You just have to
wrong?
Get, yeah, you get used to your breath. Okay, that's just on the higher octave. If you blow a little less,
okay,
it's only a little breath. No, that's a bigger breath. Now you can get that, that's the higher octave. That's it, you got it. Yay.
Can we hear a little ditty maybe? A little,
okay.
I'm expecting Fitz to come out of the woodwork over here.
Fitz is going to come running across the office.
Did somebody call me? I thought I saw the Batman symbol.
That was on the 4 euro tin whistle, that music.
Yeah, well, maybe not four, but
the
probably.
The 6 euro tin whistle.
Yeah, it was
and
a cute.
Kyle, and don't you think we should have warned people to put their dogs in
another
room?
I almost kept the section. I should dig up this section because earlier in the interview she said, yeah, I prefer the cheap ones. She said, for me, the cheaper, the better. And she goes, when it comes to tin whistles. Great,
great. So we've interviewed, a couple of years ago, I interviewed the current American ambassador to Spain, Julissa Reynoso, amazing person. I mean, she is just, if you notice, she's doing a million things. She's always in the press, kind of the opposite of our ambassador before that. She's a wonderful person. She's also been on Vaughan Radio. Richard, you've interviewed
Eddie
many.
Eddie Izzard here. Right. We're sitting in this chair.
Wow. Right, right.
Oh, yeah.
In this chair. That's a Hollywood heavyweight.
For an hour.
Mm-hmm. Love
an
Eddie.
Hour's interview with Eddie Izzard. I've also had the ambassador, three ambassadors. The Irish ambassador to Spain was here.
Mm-hmm.
The British ambassador, and the Gambian ambassador.
Oh, cool.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And the Canadian ambassador.
Some serious guests here.
With me, but yeah.
And I've had some Hollywood. I know I've had some screenwriters. The guy who wrote A League of Their Own, the story about the female baseball team with Tom Hanks. And so we've had some really, really interesting people come through here throughout the years.
Kyle had a very interesting politician, the father of the court.
I had Ron Paul on the show.
Oh, Ron Paul.
Ron Paul,
wow.
Who ran for U.S. Excellent. President a couple times.
Great.
And that was that was sort of a personal thing because I liked his message.
I like Ron
and
Paul,
talking
too.
About sort of... He's a libertarian.
We got to get Trump on here.
Big Don.
We'll have a billion listeners.
It's a fantastic program. If you look at the numbers.
China.
One of the great shows.
Yeah. Oh, man. Trump, the guy you love to hate. But you know, if he came on here, we would break audience records. We'd have people.
That would be insane.
It would be insane. And you'd probably even want a picture with him. Even
of
though
course.
You would hate to admit it, but you probably would ask him for a picture. Look at me with Trump.
Now you can go to Argentina and get a picture with
the sky.
Oh, dude. Chainsaw.
Yeah, he's changing the game.
Yeah.
He's like, Ministerio Transporte.
He's wildly entertaining. I'm anxious to see where this...
I know.
Well, I'm sure Ron Paul would be happy with that guy, by
the
way.
There's a pendulum, and the pendulum swings.
He's stripping down the government, yeah.
All right, let's not get into politics, because that is one thing that we do avoid here from time to time. But let's see. Let's hear from another listener right now, because we've got a lot of listeners sending their love.
Hello, friends. Alberto, showing no namers. This is Leo. Big shout out to all of you. And... first of all, I'd like to say thank you very much for the countless moments I've had thanks to all of you and all the English I've learned over these 20 years. To me, Richard was a visionary and a pioneer. The medium is the message, and creating a radio to promote his company to me was an incredible idea. On those days, he built an empire, and in addition to giving this country what it needly badly, which was professionals to help us learn English, as we were the worst in the world speaking English. I got hooked really soon, commuting with Cloverdale Corner, then with Alberto, of course, Kyle, Drew. Even with Elena, no English, but good for the soul. I want to send you a big hug to all of you, and once again, a thousand of thanks.
El Rincón de Cloverdale, donde entramos.
Look at that. That's Jim Traynor's voice, the one and only. Mm. Well, I'm going to tell you guys a touching story. And it kind of has to do with Vaughan Radio, because a lot of people say, oh, Alberto, you've been on Vaughan Radio. But really, I started on Vaughan TV. After you seeing me on Vaughan TV is where you said, I got to get this guy on the radio too. So it's kind of the other way around. I started on TV and then went into radio. And an amazing story. My late father-in-law was a huge Vaughan fan. He watched you religiously when we were on the Aprende Inglés TV stuff. And he told my wife, this is before we had even met, okay? And he said, you got to watch this English channel. It's really good. You'll learn. Plus, there's this one guy who's a little bit crazy, and you're going to love him.
Insidio.
And he doesn't know how right he was, because we ended up getting married. Now, he never knew that. I never met him. But that's a way that
he
I know
before
I,
you.
Yeah.
Oh,
before
you started. That's a beautiful, touching
I got his
story.
Approval wow. from. Like she told him, you're gonna love this guy. So like obviously right. he loved me, and I never met him. But he, yeah. thanks to Vaughan TV and Aprende Inglés TV, he was able to connect with me and learn English. So I've got wow. I got the green light from my father-in-law.
Brilliant, yeah. Wow. Via you know? Vaughan TV. Well done, Richard.
And we didn't realize it until years later. Like she goes, oh yeah, my dad. Oh yeah, you know, we started talking about it. She goes, plus, he loved. Wait, you're the crazy guy he was talking about. I was screaming all the time, and I'm like, yeah, that's me. That sounds about right. Loud mouth. Yeah, yeah, that's me. So
that was an Aprende Inglés TV when that's you were right. throwing the cards.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. yeah. And I have to. I don't know if you guys know it now. In retrospect, poor Raquel del Rio. I dropped a lot of double entendres in there. A lot
wait,
of them.
That was Rumbo en Inglés.
Rumbo en Inglés.
She never wore uh-huh. a pearl necklace again, Rumbo let's put English. It that way. yeah. Poor, and some people have caught me. Some people said, you son of a gun. I'm like, I was just trying to slip double. It's high level, right?
Yeah, yeah,
advanced?
Exactly.
I want to see
get
if you
it,
get
you
the
get
double
it.
Entendres. So we're always playing. We're always having fun. See, Mano, what's one of your favorite things about the new show that you're doing? The audience participation, the fact that you've got Nacho always on tenterhooks.
Yeah, I love making Nacho suffer. That's my number one, you know, aim in life.
I wake up every morning.
Exactly.
Check,
how?
Make Nacho suffer.
But I also love my little drop-ins that happen mm-hmm. frequently. You know, you're talking about important VIP guests. I get a man that has revolutionized how people, you know, learn in a whole country. I get Richard Vaughan every now and then that pops in, don't I?
I can't resist.
And that yeah. makes my day.
Sure, yeah, sure. Yeah.
So nice.
Yeah,
it's great.
Come in. And but, I, you know, it's for me, the fact that Nacho understands her. Oh, she yeah. speaks fast.
That's the thing.
She speaks fast and
well,
furious.
He doesn't
really
understand me.
Not the whole thing.
Not just like, I just nod my head. I'm not really understand. I'm just
pure yeah, intuition.
Following
no
along.
One understands me. I just had a meeting with the CEO. She was like, I don't understand you. I was like, yeah.
And what
this
language
is it.
Were you speaking in Spanish?
I'm speaking in English. I'm in Spanish. Everything. I need a new language. I'm good. Anyone
and
got
you
anything?
You teach people how to communicate? Wait a second here. Wait, what's going on here?
But it's fine. If you can understand me, you can understand anyone.
Well,
there it is.
That's true.
The ultimate challenge.
I say the same thing with one of our friends. What's her name now? I can't remember her name. Shrina.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
you can
I
understand
guess we're on a
Shrina,
level.
You pass the listening exam. Or my name. It's like
which is, and
clipping,
your
clipping.
Your daughter coming. Your
it's
daughter.
Daughter.
So my what?
Does your daughter want some water?
My daughter. My daughter. Is your daughter, does your daughter want some water?
All right. I got another trivia question, and ooh. I know you guys will know it. What two shows does Rob Grams host currently? He's hosting two shows. One he hosts by himself, and another one he co-hosts with Andrea Vaughan. What are the names of Rob Grams' two shows? Rob is another one. How much stuff does Rob do?
A lot.
A lot.
He does a lot.
And he's not
he
just sitting in front of the microphone.
He does everything because he's presenting, he's editing, he's
organizing,
producing, he's filming, he's organizing. He does it all.
Well,
he's
for
a one-man
about
production.
7 months, his name was Marta.
Right.
Because Marta films my TV program.
Right.
And I refer to her often.
Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm.
And so there was a time when she was, because of the ERTE, you know,
yeah.
because of the COVID.
Right.
Rob
layoffs.
Was and, so, and I said to Rob, I'm going to look at you and call you Marta.
And he's like, thank you.
For the next 7 months, so don't worry.
Ignore me. All right, folks, we'll be right back with tons more. Stick around. Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are having a party. We're having a party. Everybody's swinging. And ladies and gentlemen, joining us in the house, please welcome Rob Grams.
What's How are we doing, guys? It's fake Marta. Here I am.
Lost some going, hair.
How's it? Yeah, well, this is, just to say, guys, this is so special. I've been sat in the control there for the last hour and a half. So special to see you three in the studio together. Yeah. Is this the first time the three of you have done a show together?
Ooh, maybe I not.
Maybe, I don't know.
Maybe a Birken de Nuria, because I know sometimes we've jumped on each other's shows, yeah. But maybe. Either way, like planning it, like to get together, like let's do this, let's celebrate. And then it's not just the three of us. We've had Ximena drop by. You're here with us as well. Tell us one of your favorite things about working with Vaughan Radio.
Well, I can tell you about this year. Yeah. How's about that?
Sure.
This year, we've made, Vaughan Media, we've made 400 episodes of TV. There are two people in Vaughan TV. That's more.
Marta and fake Marta.
Marta and fake Marta. That's more episodes of TV than there are days in the year.
Yep.
Approximately 2,600 hours of radio content.
Wow.
Yeah. What we do, what you guys do, really, is incredible. So it's hard for me. I've been listening, obviously. I've been ushering in other radio presenters. It's hard for me to pinpoint a single time. Like my first exposure, really, the first time I met Richard, one of the very first times, was in a studio that was in someone's house. You told the story already about the gentleman, and you rented four hours of studio
equipment
time.
In the tub. No fire hazard there.
So I was studying radio production at the time.
Oh, wow.
And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. Like, this... Look at what's going on here. And I remember
this
Richard,
isn't in the textbook.
Yeah, yeah. And 20 years later, here I am working with you guys. It's just been, every moment is a privilege. I'm one of the lucky people who gets to wake up every single day, just blown away.
And you had a really great job here at Vaughan, too. So this, you know, it's hard to top the job you had, which was, you know, the welcoming guy. I don't know the name of the position. The welcoming guy at Vaughan Town. The master
El payaso.
I mean, dude, yeah, but think about it. They're linked in a certain way. You're entertaining people. You're welcoming people, and that's what you do every day on your two shows. Tell us the trivia question. What are the names of your two shows?
The morning show, the Probo show, and with the one and only Andrea Vaughan, the lunchtime show.
The lunchtime show, where I say, you guys should just call it Rob and Andy's Antics.
Yeah.
You know, because it's what it is. It's.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel like that show is like them, the listeners, getting to be a fly on the wall, a good expression, no? Like a witness to a totally native conversation. So, like, this is what Rob and Andy would sound like if they were at the corner bar having a beer, and you guys get to be in on that conversation, and that's cool.
Yeah, it's if I was to define it, I would call it a Vaughan Town simulator.
Okay.
You want to listen to a conversation between two natives. You want to put yourself through that challenge, through that test. Then that's the place to do it. And then not only that, we do it live. So if you're a Spanish speaker joining in the chat on the Twitch, then you're actually not only talking to two natives in the room, you're actually chatting with natives who join us from everywhere, from North Carolina. We have people joining us from all over the states, really, from the Netherlands. I mean, we've put together a real international community. And and what we do there is quite unique. I'm very, very proud of the lunchtime show. It's actually a shame that Andy can't be with us to
join us.
Where is she?
She's at home. She's got a headache, apparently.
All right. Andy, we'll accept the excuse, but just because you're our buddy. Oh, man. Great stuff. So we're here in the studio. Let's hear from another listener, since we have such amazing listeners.
The best.
Hi, Kyle. Good morning. It's Mercedes from Colmenar. You know me, Richard Vaughan. Knows me and Alberto Alonso, I think he could remember me. Happy anniversary for all of you. You deserve it, guys. You are hard workers and you make us feel really, really well improving our English through the radio. Happy anniversary again. A kiss, a big kiss, and a big hug for every one of you.
Awesome, awesome, really.
She's a professor of physical education at a primary school in Colmenar Viejo.
Awesome. Well, that's another thing I got to say I'm proud of here at Vaughan Radio. so many, because, you know, people come up to us at the book fair when we have events and things, and they say, hey, you know, I'm learning English with you. But then there are certain people who come up and say, hey, I'm teaching English with you.
Mm. Yeah.
So I'm a teacher, yeah, and I use you guys to make sure I'm keeping my level up, I'm getting ideas. So for me, I mean, of course, all the comments are amazing, but when I see that the teachers in Spain and, and around the world, as Rob said, use us as a reference, that is totally humbling.
And we have one, you know him as well, Luis, because both you and I think you also went to his school. He asked me to go to his school in Móstoles and teach their class once, do a big assembly, and they brought in like 200 students.
We gave out some books,
and I think you did it as well. And
I didn't know that.
Luis, the big guy who's the opera singer, and also I think he's into javelin.
Oh,
or some track and field stuff. He's a great guy.
So our listeners are not just students, they're teachers as well. And I know a lot of teachers.
He's the principal or headmaster of a school.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, they got what I noticed is all the students are as driven as he is. So he's a great leader.
Yeah.
If you walk into the school and you just feel the kids like brimming with energy, and that's great. And that's hopefully we're instilling that in him, and he's instilling it into his students, because
we've had a lot of influence on people. This month I will be giving a talk to a group of FP, Formación Profesional, age 20, and last year I gave two different to 15 and 16 year olds.
Right,
you know, through Javier Prieto, an ex teacher of ours who works there. No, we're doing a service, a very special service.
And our materials, not just our radio too, but like how many teachers go into the Vaughan Tienda and say, I'm going to use these translation lists in my class. I'm going to study phrasal verbs from this book because it's all here. Or the Business English Bible, as I call it. You know, any teacher who's doing an MBA should have that book as a reference. You know,
I've always said when people ask, I said it's the best business English book that's available.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Kyle means business.
Indeed.
Not Johnny, did a clip that, please? No.
Kyle, that's a good name for a show for you. Kyle means business, a business podcast.
There you go.
See, I'm giving a couple ideas for you. Kyle means business. I would listen to it. All right. Well, folks, let's listen to another listener because we do have a lot of clips from listeners. So let's see who we've got up next.
Hey, Alberto, I'm Franz. This is Nuria once again. As for this week's question, what my earliest memory was, well, it happens to me very often when I think back on my childhood, those good old times, but well, this is another story. Let's focus on my earliest memory. This was last week while I was having a coffee with my best friend. We started to talk, and as she thought back to her aunt recently passed away, tears came to her eyes, and I also burst into tears.
All right, hang on, guys. I mixed it up. Sorry, that's not Nacho's fault. That's question of the week. That's for show with no name.
I think she loved us.
We're going down a wild path there.
If you guys want to participate in the question of the week, like Nuria did, we'll hear them on Friday. We do a section where you guys send us 1 minute voice message, and I help you with your pronunciation, and you express yourself in English. So that's her telling us about her earliest memory. That's for another show. Nacho, let's see who else we've got. My bad over there. It wasn't Nacho's fault.
Good morning, everyone. This is Elena. I remember the first time I discovered you guys. It was through you, Alberto. I remember being channel surfing one afternoon, and all of a sudden, there was a young Alberto giving a face-to-face class to a young woman. And I was just taken aback by the way English was taught in such a different way that it blew my mind. Apparently, there weren't any boring grammar exercises or endless explanations. It was fun, drilling back and forth, questions and answers, correcting every single mistake. So from that moment on, I got hooked and I wanted to know everything about Vaughan. I ended up being a regular listener and a participant in your program. So a toast for you all, for the effort that really comes through, and we all would come through for you. Hopefully.
Excellent. Bye-bye. Vocab, confidence.
Incredible.
It's excellent. Really, really. Our listeners, I always say, they're our ambassadors. When people are out there and they say, how did you learn it? How did you understand them? How do you feel so confident? That's where they say, Vaughan Radio. Oh,
wow. Yeah.
So they're the proof.
In fact, there are a lot of, I've met now at my current age, people come up to me in the book fair and said, My father obligated me to listen to you sitting in the backseat when he was taking me to school. I remember.
Like,
I
you're making it sound like a punishment.
I was only 8 years old.
You're welcome. Now you speak English.
Exactly.
Wow. Yeah, yeah. It's come a long way. I mean, since I've been here. Now, let me ask you this, Richard. Are there any moments where you thought about closing up shop, where you thought,
Never.
Ooh.
Closing up
the
radio?
I mean, not because it wasn't successful, but you thought, okay, it's run its course. I don't know. Any point where you had doubts, or always been 100% on board with it?
The radio is the most fascinating project of my life. Mm. It was not the most difficult. It was an easy project. Mm. Vaughan Town was the toughest project to get
out
of port.
Sure.
Yeah.
I have a question here about this. When Vaughan Radio was launched, what was the management of the company like? I mean, you had Michael Choi, a name that some of us might remember.
But I was still managing.
Obviously, you were the boss. But what I'm getting at is, I'm wondering what the reaction was when you said to everyone on the management, "Hey, we're going to go all in and spend a fortune, really, on a radio station."
Nobody supported me.
I bet.
They didn't not support me, but nobody thought it was. They thought I was crazy.
All right.
Even my daughter.
Yeah. Normally, that's how you know you've got a good idea. It's polarized.
Well, the thing is,
because if everybody's like, great idea, then
someone's done it already.
No. People were afraid. I mean, they said, wait, because you see, we put up a pirate radio signal first.
Sure, sure.
Later but I knew that even if the signal was illegal, it was protected because the wife of the person that would close us would say, "Don't you dare touch Vaughan Radio.
You touch them, I'll break your legs."
Yeah. So I knew that the goodness of the content was going to protect us until we could get legal.
Sure, sure.
See? Because if we tried to do it legally from the beginning, we would never.
Spain is different.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to walk in the gray area
Loopholes, right? Los tecnicismos, right? Yeah. The loopholes over there. Yeah. Well, it's great, and it's a good thing. And, you know, I think about it often. I know everybody, all these companies get grants, subvenciones. This should be almost like publicly funded. This is a service.
Absolutely.
This company has never received, nor have we sought, a single subsidy.
Mm-hmm. But this based on the what we're offering, you know, to the population, I mean, it's something that would, in the United States, be considered for subsidies.
This is interesting. We have concursado. I mean, we have bid for a radio station in 9 comunidades autónomas.
Okay.
And we've lost in all 9. I mean, 0-9 is de por goleada against us.
Yeah.
That means the political class is not really that interested in this initiative of ours, providing English free to the people in Aragon or in Mallorca.
Because then they'll go to Germany and earn double their salary. Yeah.
I don't know.
I think
the political class, they give it to friends and enemies, to placate enemies and to help out friends.
I'm sure you've got this message many times because I get it a lot too. People say, why aren't you on the radio and they name their city, Granada,
or something.
And it's and I always go back. Look, it's not free. This is not a government. You know, if an antenna were free, we'd love to be everywhere. But it's expensive, and it has to make sense, and it has to make sense from a business perspective, right?
Well, pretty soon, hopefully, I'm talking to. Well, no, actually, this is a big spoiler.
Do we have a drum roll over here?
For 20 years, Rob, what are you waiting for?
The only person.
No one knows yet.
The only person who knows this is Natch because he was listening to the meeting. Yeah, hopefully soon we may be making it back to some TV brands, some cars all around Europe, worldwide, on digital radio.
Whoa.
Great.
Hopefully. Cool. Let's see. Fingers crossed. Yeah.
All right. Do you have to pay cars to be in their radio?
No, there are certain digital broadcasters, digital networks. One in particular that's one of the biggest here in Europe, expanding into Latin America soon. If you're listening, radioplayer.org, we love you.
Yeah.
And they have a special deal with BMW, with Renault, with a few car manufacturers.
Yeah. Cool.
And so if you're a listener to Vaughan Radio, stay tuned, friends. If you've got certain models of cars, if you're a digital radio listener, you can keep up with your favorite radio shows all around the world.
That's great. And again, in the meantime, if you're not getting that signal, the Vaughan Radio app is free. And you can take us wherever, whenever.
Or you can go back in time through iVox and listen to programs from 1 year ago.
Sure.
Yep. Yeah.
Sure. Absolutely. iVox, Apple Podcasts, wherever Spotify. You listen to them, Spotify as well. And we've got a YouTube page, which I always tell people, you know, go there. There's
Is it live?
Hours
there?
There are hours and hours and hundreds of hours of videos of Richard and myself.
We're actually on Amazon Play now. We're on a bunch of places. A couple of years ago, I opened up. Unavoidable.
It's funny when you offer something free for the consumer. If they lose it, they go.
Yeah. Well, what the heck? What happened?
And they get really angry. It's like, well, you know, you weren't paying. This is free, you know. And they learn to want the free stuff, which is good.
So I've had people who complained.
We would love to be everywhere.
About me, because I'm a loud mouth sometimes, and I'm like, oh, we'll just give you your money back. Then.
What do you mean sometimes?
Well, I've had people be like, this guy's a loud mouth. This guy, I don't agree with him or whatever. Which is fine. I don't think we should all agree. That would be a weird world. where we're all agreeing on stuff. And I've always said, oh, don't worry, we'll return every dime you paid. Okay, we get a full money back guarantee. Change the channel. I don't like most things on TV. I don't watch TV.
Well, you know, it's strange about this. I said 99% of everything we receive is very, very
Absolutely.
Positive.
Absolutely. Yeah,
there's
yeah.
the 1% that's a bit
strange.
Oh,
I love them, please. The worst thing that they never told you. I need this.
The one I remember the most was a British lady who lived here and took her children to the British Council, to school. And she wrote a handwritten letter and said, now we are returning to the United Kingdom. Finally, I won't have to listen to your horrible show.
Can I tell mine?
You're like, good riddance. Good riddance. Go back to your rainy country and eat your soggy fish and chips.
This has just brought back memories.
No offense to you guys.
No.
You guys are Spaniards now, anyway.
I received a 10-page letter from an inmate in a jail.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's better than my story.
And I was really, it's like the first page started off quite like, you know, with Vaughan Radio, I've improved my listener. Got to page like 4. And you, with your incessant laughing, your incessant positivity, have met, you know, and it was just like.
I'm not the one in jail, buddy.
Page.
Come and get me.
Come get me, mofo.
You've made every day in this jail worse because I. No, I don't think it said that.
Things
it was
were
incredible.
Great in here until you came along.
I've just remembered it. I'm going to show you that letter. I've got it there at home.
I received one once. 300 pages.
I see your 10 pages.
No. Isn't that called War and Peace?
No, wait a minute. No, I'll tell you. He said, these 300 pages is 1 month of Cloverdale's Corner that I transcribed.
Oh, well, that's love.
Wow. I said, I'm not sure if that's the best way to approach learning English. You see.
Yeah. Also, Kyle mentioned during one of the breaks, we've got a lot, and I know this too because I've worked with a lot of famous soccer players, footballers. They listen to us. Like Real Madrid players, Atletico players listen to us. And there's even a video with Cristiano Ronaldo going to his training ground. He's like,
Going to Valdebebas.
Going to Valdebebas and saying, yo aprendiendo el inglés un poco cada día con el profesor Vaughan. I'm like, you couldn't pay for that.
Yeah.
Couldn't. I mean, that would cost a couple million to have him say that. And he did it because he knew the. So look at that. So footballers, people who are, you know, they know the value of Vaughan Radio. Just we need the government now to realize it.
the army as well. I mean, in 2 weeks, I'm going to the Academia de Artillería Segovia. Every year I go to give a talk. I am what you call Infante de Honor del Ejército.
Ooh, should we be calling you sir?
And the Joint Chiefs of Staff gave it to me personally.
Oh, wow.
He said, we listen to you in the Army gym. Wow. It's mandatory. Wow.
It's mandatory. That's great. No, it's really working at Vaughan. And for me, too, it's opened up many doors to meet some amazing people, famous people, musicians, artists. And because they listen to us. Because honestly, I think anybody who's international.
But how did you meet Damian?
Damian was a fan of ours. So we were doing one of the shows on Aprende Inglés TV, and they said, oh, you're going to go interview the guys at El Hormiguero. And I'm like, oh, I've heard of that show. I don't watch TV, so I didn't, you know. And I said, oh, cool. And I was like, well, that's fun. He goes, well, no, he's kind of like, he asked for you. He said, you're his man. Like, he wants you, and he's only going to do it if it's you. And I said, oh, wow. And the rest is history. We met. We were making jokes the whole time we filmed, cracking jokes left and right. And the next day, we were having mojitos in Wank Square, Plaza de la Paja. and the rest is history, honestly. You know, he's been to my house in the States.
Teaches you paddle, doesn't
he? We've written 3 books together. He's my paddle teacher and my brother from another mother. And it all started because he listened to Vaughan Radio and watched us. And he's like, I want that guy. If you're going to come. It. And then that opened the door to meet a lot of other people. Pablo, Jorge, the producers over there. And I got to say it, no matter where I go, I can go to a little town somewhere. And Damian, I mean, he's el flipa. He's just like, what? We can be hiking in like a little town with a population of 10. And someone's like, ah, Alberto Vaughan, Yosco. And he's like, dude, my show is seen by millions of people every night. And they recognized you in a little village. And it's not the first time.
Yeah, like, I'll tell you,
we're everywhere.
I'll tell you a funny story. Similar thing. I was teaching someone who, maybe I won't say her name, but she's quite famous on television, and she contacted me to teach her a private class. So I go to meet her, and she said, well, let's go to this rest. We went to a Bips back when Bips had the bookstores, and she said, my new book is out. Well, we were just going to get to know each other a little bit. She said, we'll go to the Bips. So we go and said, oh, my new book is out. Let's see if my book is here. So we walk into the Bips. We're looking around. She couldn't find her book. We keep going down the aisle, and there was my business English book sitting there. It's like, oh, well, there's my book. Well, there's my book. Where's yours? And she, I think it kind of pissed her off a little bit. She also said to me in that class, so how's my accent? Is it more British or American? I said, your accent is Spanish.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like, let's be honest here. But yeah. But yeah, and we have good distribution with our materials and our books. And
everybody,
it's great to see
everybody
it out there.
Listens to us, I think, in all different walks of life too.
Remember,
not just footballers, but you know, taxi drivers.
When Richard Brown and I used to go and teach the oldest man on television, do you remember? Oh, no, the youngest man on television, Jordi Hurtado. What's his? Host of Saber y Ganar, that they say never ages. He's been there for years and years.
Yeah, that's right. We've done
been
TV
everywhere.
Stuff, El Hormiguero. I mean. Best-selling books. Really, it's been an amazing adventure. And that's I think, this radio station is one of the things that attracted me to Vaughan before I even worked here. That, and I remember my first time going into the office, Eduardo Dato, I believe, was it Eduardo Dato?
Yeah.
And then there was a poster, one of these framed write-ups, an article. And it was a very young Richard Vaughan.
He's also, he doesn't age. Look at him.
No, but this was him. Like, he looked like he was 25, 30 years old. And I just remember looking at that article and being like, get the fuck out of here. This guy started a town in the middle of Spain. I'm like, this is genius.
Who is this guy?
I seriously was just in awe. And I was like, this sounds like the kind of company. And they have a radio station. And they have a publisher.
I was convinced it was a cult. I genuinely was nervous for our interview.
A lot of people still are.
We're not convinced
of that.
No, over the years, some people have thought we were a cult.
I was absolutely convinced. And when you just hear
the cult of personality, we are. The cult of personality. Well, if you guys
don't drink the magic potion every morning?
I do. Kyle, if learning English is a sin, then I don't want to be right.
Well, it is true we are a cult in one thing, in how we recruit and train teachers, create teachers. It's almost like a cult.
You do it
this way. This is the way to do it. The other way doesn't work.
Sure. And I've noticed it too now with my daughter. The Vaughan method is how kids learn.
Yeah.
Like what you've done is taken how a kid naturally learns a language and put it into like a format. Because every day with my daughter, is this a monkey? And I notice I get a lot more, I get her to participate a lot more when I get the negative.
Right.
Is this, my panties? No, Dad, they aren't yours.
Well, yeah, with my daughter, when she was really, I used to make her rabiar, tease her.
You're right. Yeah. Then you get them to react, and they're like, oh, now you're talking.
And she would react like, there's a song, Girl of My Dreams, I love you, honest I do, you are so sweet. And I said, Girl of My Nightmares. I said, no, Papa, dreams.
Yeah.
I hate you. No, but I love you. Honest I don't. No, it's honest I do.
Nice.
She was serious.
Oh, yeah. Great, great. So these techniques work. It's the Vaughan Method. Guys, thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you guys from the bottom of our hearts. I speak on behalf of not just the people at Vaughan Radio, but all of us here at Vaughan. Thanks for being a part of our family and to another 20 years. Thanks to everybody who was here today.
Thanks for organizing this, Alberto. It's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, all right.
Welcome, amazing. Alberto.
All right, folks, and stick around because Ximena's up next. Hello. With Test Your English. Ciao for now.